What's up, guys? Welcome back to my channel, or welcome if you're new here. I am Bella, a cat's mom. Aww. And this is my channel where I talk about programming, gaming, and fitness. So today's video is the first one in a new series that I'm working on, where I talk about the history of some special woman in technology. And our person of the day is Ada Lovelace. She is regarded as the first author of a computer program, even though she lived over a century before the modern computer was even invented. Wow. She was the first one to recognize that Charles Babbage's mechanical general purpose computer could potentially do more than pure calculations. She wrote then the first algorithm intended to be carried out by this machine that he created. And what was this machine? It was the analytical engine. The analytical engine was a mechanical and steam-powered computer first described in 1837 by Charles Babbage, the father of computers. It included a central processing unit called the mill, and expandable memory, which was called by Charles as the store. Controlled by punched cards, which could be used to input data, the engine could be programmed to carry out several and different mathematical operations. The logical structure of this engine was essentially the same as that which had dominated the computer design in the electronic era. It can also be called Turing complete. Now let's get back to Ada. Enough of Charles. Let's get back to our special girl. Her father, Lord Byron, was expecting actually a glorious boy and was pretty disappointed when his wife, Lady Byron, gave birth to a girl in London, 1815. He separated from his wife probably because he was so disappointed that such a terrible news, it was a girl. So he separated his wife and left England forever after 4 months. Ada's father, Lord Byron, was a poet, but he always encouraged her to pursue a career in science, as did her mother. Lord Byron died in Greece when Ada was 8 years old. Ada married William King, who was made Earl of Lovelace in 1838. Ada thereby became Countess of Lovelace. That's why we called her Ada of Lovelace. Ada described her scientific approach as poetical science and herself as an analyst and metaphysician. Ada was 17 when she first met Charles Babbage, and he was 42. He was a mathematics professor at the University of Cambridge at the time, and despite the big difference in age between Ada and Charles, they were mentally actually pretty close and paused for scientific thinking. In 1843, Babbage actually asked Ada to translate a short description of his engine that was written by an Italian mathematician. For 9 months, that's all she did, but she did more. She also added some of her own set of notes, including corrections to Babbage's mathematical calculations. The final transcript was actually 3 times longer than the original translation. She also described how this machine could be potentially used to calculate an arcane parentheses sequence of figures known as the Bernoulli numbers. By diagramming the computations that this machine would have to make, she proved that it would be possible. And that, believe it or not, is how it looked like. Essentially, she had written the first computer algorithm. With that, she also demonstrated that the machine could actually manipulate anything within a set of rules, either for practical or scientific purposes. She even said that one day this machine could potentially be capable of composing elaborated pieces of music of any complexity or extent. Basically, stuff we do with our computers nowadays. Although the machine was actually never built, her publication was very well received by the scientific community, and she got a lot of fans, including the pioneer electrochemist Michael Faraday. Ada unfortunately died at the age of 36 in 1852 of uterine cancer. It was only 100 years later that her work was republished, when people actually started building those computers that she envisioned. And then it became clear how precise she was. I hope you guys enjoyed this video. Click the like button if you did, subscribe, click the bell, stay safe, stay healthy, and see you guys in the next video. I'm out.